Well, recently, Honda has collaborated with GM and Sony on electric vehicles. Maybe something huge is coming up, but the company's developing its solid-state battery technology, which is risky for business, though great news apparently. Honda believes in technology you can enjoy and has a full-fledged plan to beat the moving forward Toyota. So hello, tech fans, welcome back to Tech Addicts, and without any further ado, fasten your seatbelt as we're about to go for a drive. Are you ready? A report by Ars Technica states comments from executives at a media roundtable at Honda's Tokyo headquarters as saying the company plans to invest 43 billion yen, or about 290 million US dollars at current exchange rates, to build a demonstration solid-state battery production line in Sakura, a city in Japan's Tochigi Prefecture, with an expected opening in spring 2024. Solid-state batteries are expected to be included in Honda's production vehicles by the end of the decade, perhaps in 2028 or 2029, according to Shinji Aoyama, Honda's worldwide leader of electrification. Other automakers and battery companies are also working to perfect this technology to extend a vehicle's range and decrease charging times. According to reports from the roundtable, Honda's worldwide CEO, Toshihiro Mibe, said that the company hasn't chosen which vehicle will be the first to adopt solid-state batteries, but that he hopes to see them used in motorbikes as well as cars. In 2021, Honda joined a coalition of Japanese motorcycle manufacturers to develop battery swapping standards for bikes, and by 2025, it expects to release 10 new electric motorbikes globally, some of which will be sold in the United States. However, Honda researchers need to resolve a lifetime issue with solid-state batteries before they can be used in any automobile. In testing its experimental solid-state cells, the automaker discovered that lithium dendrites, which are spikes of material that grow over time and can create short circuits during charging, affected the cells more than others. To solve this problem without compromising battery performance, Honda's added fabric layers between the solid electrolyte, thus the term solid-state. Honda claims that the materials can be coupled with a roll press to produce thinner layers. If this method proves effective before the 2024 launch of the Japanese pilot manufacturing line, it will be expanded to other facilities across the world, maybe including Honda's upcoming battery facility in Ohio. Honda isn't the only car maker working on solid-state battery technology. Other manufacturers like BMW and Ford are testing solutions from outside startups. As a result, Nissan is developing its unique solid-state cells, which it believes will be the catalyst for the widespread adoption of electric sport utility vehicles and pickup trucks. Honda is keeping this investigation in-house, but has plans to release a line of EVs co-created with other companies. The 2024 Honda Prologue SUV will be the first vehicle to use GM's Ultium platform. By 2027, millions of inexpensive EVs might roll off a production line jointly developed by Honda and GM. Their cell format will be smaller than that of the Prologue, Acura ZDX, Hummer EV, Cadillac Lyriq, and many other upcoming vehicles. The first Honda Sony EVs will be assembled in 2025 in North America at a Honda factory, although Honda's not yet specified how much technology would be shared with the joint venture established earlier this year. On Tuesday, Honda announced plans to invest $700 million to convert three of its plants in Ohio to produce electric vehicles as part of its commitment to stop producing vehicles with gas engines entirely by 2040. A partnership with LG Energy Solutions will ensure a steady supply of batteries for Honda and Acura EVs. The manufacturers announced that, subject to regulatory permission, the $4.4 billion battery plant will be built in Fayette County, Ohio, close to Honda's current activities there. To control supply and access to breakthrough battery technologies, the automotive industry is scrambling to bring battery production onshore, and the new EV center will utilize Honda's manufacturing and purchasing network in central Ohio to do so. According to Alex Partners, automakers and suppliers have pledged over $38 billion in investment through 2026 to increase domestic battery output. This number is expected to climb as companies take advantage of the $40 billion in tax incentives included in the Inflation Reduction Act to speed up the production of electric vehicles. The F-150 Lightning and a second battery electric truck are just two examples of the kind of electric vehicles that Ford wants to produce once construction on its $5.6 billion Blue Oval City complex in Tennessee is complete in 2025. Midway through this decade, Toyota will have spent $3.8 billion on a battery plant for hybrid and battery electric vehicles near Greensboro, North Carolina. Panasonic, a supplier to Tesla and other automakers, has announced plans to build a $4 billion battery plant in Kansas, the largest economic development project in the state's history, and is in preliminary talks to build a similar facility in Oklahoma. Honda and LG Energy plan to start building in the first quarter of next year and start manufacturing the advanced lithium-ion battery cells by the year's end. An initial $3.5 billion will be invested by the joint venture, with a total investment of $4.4 billion expected. Although this is a far cry from the 100,000 electric vehicles and hybrids that Honda sold in the United States in the previous year, led by hybrid versions of its Accord sedan and CR-V crossover, Honda plans to increase manufacturing in order to sell millions of electric vehicles in North America. The Honda E architecture will be used to produce vehicles beginning in 2026. However, the company is currently co-developing models utilizing General Motors' Ultium platform in preparation for the launch of the Prologue, its first battery electric SUV, in 2024. The Honda E architecture will be used to produce vehicles beginning in 2026. The investment of $700 million that Honda is making in its existing plant footprint in Ohio will allow for the facilitation of the conversion of its Anna engine plant to the production of battery cases, its Marysville auto plant to the assembly of battery modules, and its East Liberty auto plant to the production of electric vehicles. Electrification strategies for the Honda and Toyota EVs. Both Honda and Toyota have stated that their approach to electric vehicles is similar to that of a tortoise and the hare, but that they will move more quickly in the near future. Executives from Honda claimed recently at a briefing on the car electrification sector that the period of the popularization of EVs will not come until the second half of the 2020s. This prediction was made by the executives during a discussion on the industry. However, the signs from the market suggest that the time to act is now. Throughout the past 12 months, Hyundai Motor Company has introduced a wide range of all-electric vehicles. Over the past year, Ford has entered the electric game with its alluring Mustang Mach-E and highly acclaimed F-150 Lightning, while Hyundai's Ioniq range of EVs continues to develop in addition to a readily available Kona EV, and Kia's portfolio expands with a new EV6 alongside the Niro EV. The electric vehicle race, Honda vs. Toyota. The latest Toyota electric vehicle deviates significantly from the brand's standard procedure. As a matter of fact, it feels unfinished. The bZ4X's range is below average compared to its rivals, with EPA estimates sitting at around 240 miles. With a 0-60 time of 7.1 seconds, it's smack dab in the middle of the pack. The bZ4X is without a frunk, which is a major drawback. In fact, it doesn't even have a spare tire. In contrast to Toyota, which often fails to impress, the bZ4X takes this into account. Toyota appears to have put in less effort towards its creation, and it seems more likely that the corporation hurried to get something out the door to tide them over until they could introduce a more fully featured electric vehicle. So, time's a-ticking. Starting in early 2024, the Honda Prologue will be available as a rival to the bZ4X, and time will tell if Honda's investment paid off. Concurrently, the rivals will keep gaining ground. So it's totally up to you which model to choose, as you need to touch the perfection, or you believe in performance first. Do share with us your choice in the comment section below. And that's it for today's video. We'll be back with more soon. Please like our video and subscribe to our channel.